blasting, billowing, bursting forth with the power of 10 billion butterfly sneezes.
This is Wine, Money, and Song. And if you're interested in wine and you want to learn about the best values in wine, please subscribe. So this is the final episode concerning the 2022 Bordeaux Futures. Now, it's been a lot of work compiling all the prices, and I want you to use these tables that I've done over the last 5 weeks, and we're going to do one more table for the final wines that have been released this week. All the prices are out. Try to compare it to the other vintages. There's a few wines that really stand out that I wouldn't buy. I think the price of Léoville Lascasse at $370 is an incredibly high price, and you could buy the older vintages for less money from really great vintages. And there's a few like that. I'm not ragging on Léoville Lascasse. They make great wine, but I just think the price is a little too steep. And some of the Pomerols, especially, the prices are very high. $300, Lavangil, Figeac's $350, Pabie's $409. I go, that's very risky buying those at those prices. So first I wanted to explain, this is supposed to be about best values. And what value is price plus quality equals value, all right? And I'm all about value. I'm all about value. So the wines I'm going to name at the end of this episode are about values. They're not necessarily the top quality wines. It's price and quality value. So the prices are up about 20%. Over the last year. And as I said before, the tables that I've given you shows you the other four vintages before. So use them if you're thinking about buying. And a lot of the older vintages, you might have to buy at auction, or you might have to search hard to get the wine shipped to you. But some of the wines offer a very good value, the older ones. And what I'm doing here is telling you the best values of the 2022. Let's talk about the first growths. I was surprised that the first growths came out a little lower than I thought they were going to come out. And I give them kudos for that. I thought they were going to come out between 7.25 and 8.25. They came out about $50 less than that. So, and almost all the first growths are really good. The only first growth that I'm a little worried about is Margaux. Margaux has 14.6% alcohol. That's the highest that they've ever booked ever in any vintage. And that scares me. And that scares me about the vintage. We're going to have to be careful down the road if these high alcohols take a toll on these wines. So just keep that in mind. But I think the first growths, if you're a first growth buyer, I would look very close at the first growths, because I think they weren't crazy and the quality is very high. As far as the Pomerols, like the Eau-Sartan, La Fleur Petrus, La Vangil, all those, they're very high priced. And take a look at them. I think you're better off looking back on some of the older vintages, but there's going to be some outstanding wines in Pomerol and Saint-Emilion. So it's up to you what value is to you. And just remember, one person's value is not another person's value. So I'm going to have three different lists of the best values of the 2022 Bordeaux Futures. The first category is best values under $50. The second list is best values under $100. And the third list is the best values over $100. Can you consider wines a good value, $100, $200? Yes, you can. And I'll explain why. So I call these the fabulous sevens. I'm going to have seven from each category. And remember, these are not necessarily the highest quality wines, the top rated, but what I feel, quality and price. So let's get started with the wines under $50. And if you're starting out collecting wine and with this vintage, I would start heavily on the wines under $50 and maybe a few of the wines under $100. And I wouldn't buy cases. I would buy six bottles, or even three bottles, if you're first getting started. So the first wine under $50 is Chateau Cantamero, which is a fifth growth Omadoc and has been making very quietly outstanding wines for the last 3 or 4 decades. And what you get in Cantamero is a very solid, very classic Bordeaux style. It ages very well. And at $33 for this Omadoc, it should be $50, the wine. The second wine is Chateau Mainey from Saint Estèphe at $35. And Mainey's been making very good wines. They had a period of mediocrity back in the 90s and the early 2000s. But since 2005, the wines have been excellent. They're not on the level of Montrose, Coestanel, or Calon Segura, but they're very solid. They age well and they're delicious wines. The third wine is a Pomerol, Chateau de Salle, and it's the largest estate in Pomerol. So at $33, it's very inexpensive. But in good vintages and in hot vintages, they do well. I remember buying the 82 De Salle, and it aged very well. It was delicious. The same with the 2000, 2005, 2009. And this is a vintage to buy. It's on limestone sandy soil. And at $33, you get a nice Pomerol. The next wine, which is a screaming value to me, and I've been so enlightened the last few years with Langobarton, the sister chateau of Léobaud-Barton, which is very different in style. Léobaud-Barton's a bigger style, a riper style, more serious. But the Langobarton is so elegant. When I had the 2019 Léobaud-Barton, it spun my head how elegant it was and really, really delicious. And you're going to get a great value for $50 for the Langobarton. That's a screaming value. The next wine is Chateau Gloria. And Chateau Gloria is well known. It has a big production to Saint-Julien. It's in the Henri Martin family. And they make very, very elegant, typical wines from Saint-Julien that age well. They're not overly complex, but they're still delicious Bordeaux. The next wine is Tour de Christophe, which is a Saint Emilion, and I don't know, it was 5 or 6 years. You know, there was some years ago, there was a change in ownership, and the new ownership just poured money into the chateau, and I started drinking the wines in 2015, and I bought the wines every year, 15, 16. I didn't buy 17, but I bought 18, 19, and 20. And the 22 is outstanding at $36. And these wines are going to go up in price. These wines, the next vintage, I'm sure will be $45, $50, and they're going to go up. So this is an opportunity to grab it now. The last wine under $50 is Saucian d'Aumale, Omadoc, at $41. That should be a classified growth. Very sturdy. Very sturdy Bordeaux, ages well. The 82, the 90, and the 2000, and all the way down make outstanding value. So pick that up. The next category of the Fabulous Seven is Best Under 100. And I start out with two wines from Saint-Julien. Chateau Lagrange and Brandy de Cru. And Lagrange has been very consistent, very elegant wine, and at $60, all the older vintages are delicious, and you should really look at that and pay attention to it. And Brenard du Cru Saint-Julien, similar, very elegant. I remember the 2000 vintage. Once it was bottled at our office, we did a big tasting, and I pulled out Brenard du Cru 2000 as the best value of all the classified growths. And that's saying a lot. And this wine's $60 also. The next wine is Chateau Talbot from Saint-Julien. And if you remember, 6 months ago, I called the 2019 Talbot as one of the best wines of the 2019 tasting at the Union de Grand Cru. And 2 months later, the Wine Spectator came out and rated it the top fourth wine of the whole vintage that they had last year. So we've kind of affirmed each other's opinion. So Talbot. The next wine is a favorite of mine, Grand Prix Lacoste from Pouliac at $85. It's a little higher than the past few vintages, but it's an outstanding wine. And what I call Grand Prix Lacoste is the poor man's first growth. And these wines have been outstanding for 50 years. The next wine is Léoville Barton at 95 points. There's a lot, and it's a Saint-Julien, and there's whispers in the wine industry in Bordeaux that Léoville Barton was the equal or even better than Léoville Lascasse in this vintage. And it's $95 versus $370 for the Léoville Lascasse. Enough said. Léoville Barton, look at it. The next wine is Gros La Rose at $99. It's up a little bit, 10-15%. But it's a second growth Saint-Julien, classic Bordeaux. It's getting richer and richer the last few vintages. Very age-worthy and delicious. Don't miss that. You should think about it. The last wine is Domaine de Chevalier from Graves. And Patrick Olivier has been making great wines at Domaine de Chevalier for many decades now. And at $80, it's right up there, top four or fifth wine in Graves. I remember a year and a half ago, I was at a restaurant and I had a bottle. Someone bought a bottle of the 70 Domaine de Chevalier. And it was wonderful. It was absolutely wonderful. It was classic claret. It had a lot of fruit. It was so elegant, and it still had time left. And great fruit, great balance, great wine, and a great claret. So the last category is wines under 100. All right. First, I'm going to talk about Le Carme Aubryon. And one of the first episodes, I said this wine is going to be the hot wine of the vintage. This is the flavor of the month, or maybe of the year, of the vintage. Everyone's talking about this wine. And I said the first price was around $175. And I said it's going to go up 50% quickly. Guess what? It took 2 weeks to get up 50%. They're selling it now for $250. And if you can get it at that price, I don't know. It's up to you if you want to pay up. But be very careful with this wine because it's very different than the other Graves wines because it has a large portion, I think it's 60% Cabernet Franc. And it's very old Cabernet Franc, like 90 to 100 years. And they use like 60% whole cluster fermentation. They do it very different, and the people from Chapoutier are involved in running the chateau, and they use the methods that they use in the Northern Rhone. They're very avant-garde in their winemaking, and that's what they've done with this wine. One of the YouTubers have said that Le Carme has made better wine than Aubryon. Now, I don't know about that, but I don't think they're comparable. Because Aubryon has a very small amount of Cabernet Franc, and they don't do whole clusters. And Aubryon's been making wines for centuries, and these guys have not. they've made a lot of changes, and we don't know how this wine's going to age. Now, everyone's telling me how wonderful it is, but that's good. But don't think for a second that, you know, don't give up on Obreon thinking that's an inferior wine. But the price, if you want to pay for it now, you can. The next wine under 100 is Chateau Cliné from Pomerol. Now, Cliné's never been a favorite of mine. It's a big, chunky, special, full-blown Pomerol. And at 115, that's a good price. And other vintages from good vintages have gone way up. And if you like that big style, Cliné looks like a good bet. The next wine from Saint-Emilion is Chateau Canon, which is owned by Chanel. And it's 167. The price is up a little, you know, somewhat, but Canon makes great wines. And past vintages are going up fast and very classic wines. And I think if you, especially if you haven't had many of the wines in your cellar, this is a vintage to buy. The next wine is Calon Segur, which is outstanding in this vintage. It's 150. And if you consider Montrose is at 215, that's 35% difference. And there are whispers about Calon Segur, maybe it's a little better than Montrose. I go, I don't know that, because the styles are very different. Montrose is a really big brooding style. Calon Segur is more elegant. But you should consider that a really good value, Calon Segur. The next wine is another Chanel property, Rosanne Segla, at 120. And at 120, from the area of Margaux, Parma's at 380. So how much difference is that? That's 65% less than Parma. Now, Parma's outstanding and considered to be the best wine in Margaux after Chateau Margaux is. But Rosanne Segla, the last few vintages, the wine is more elegant and more velvety. And this is a wine at 120 you should consider really top. And I spoke about Montrose at 215. The past vintages of Montrose are going for close to 270, 300. 215 sounds reasonable to me and an outstanding vintage. And the last wine is Lynch-Bage, 2022 at 145. And Lynch-Bage, you know, has a great history. And it's been very, very consistent. And this is a wine that's going to age well. Pauillac, classical style wine. So there are the wines. 2022 best values. Go out there, use the charts that I gave you, but these wines that I just mentioned, you should really look hard at these. And hopefully, it's been very helpful for you in making your buying decision.